We're all familiar with particles and waves.
What if I throw this particle to the ground?
Of course it can't pass. We all know that.
But what if I can throw an electron at a floor like this?
Would that be repelled like the golf ball? It is said that this electron I throw actually has a chance to pass the ground. What makes this difference is the scale. You know that when your mom shouts from across the other side of the house, you get what you hear because the sound is a wave. Waves can pass through a wall because it is energy, not a solid particle. So, according to quantum mechanics, every material should have both a state of solid and a state of energy. In other words, partly particle and partly a wave at the same time. Back in our big world, the wave character of materials around us is too small for us to perceive. But as the scale goes down, smaller and smaller, the wave characteristics become more significant. It's not over yet. What if we could scale even further down into the smallest, the very bottom level, of course even below the atomic scale? You can easily postulate that the wave character will be more and more pronounced, and eventually enter into a world with nothing but wave character. These tiny vibrating waves are called strings. Sounds good enough. We can create any possible sounds only by manipulating these four strings of a violin. String theory works pretty much the same. If a string vibrates this and that way, different elements are made, making up what we call material, and of course the rest of the universe as well. The theory, which currently is only mathematically proven perfect, may eventually proceed to become an important magnifying glass of seeing into the universe. So until then, let us keep our hopes high.